you to give us an application. Come on over, fill it out with us, and then we will set up a test date for our diagnostic test, which you know, if you listen at all regularly, that is in reading and math. And we will always place your child in the grade in which they will succeed. And sometimes that means they might have to drop a grade or so, because it's a disservice to place a child where he or she will not be successful and will not succeed, and then they become miserable at school and miserable at home, and life turns real ugly for everybody. So that's why we do what we do, and some parents gladly and willingly accept that, and others might not like that, and then they can, of course, take their child elsewhere. But we want to really make sure that kids get placed right so that they can develop, literally, you've heard it before, but to their full potential. That's what we're trying to seek. And right now, good morning, camera. How are you today? We just were right on Channel 17 right now. Good morning or good evening. It's probably Monday night, about 7:30. Howdy! Glad to see you there. Oh, I'm in this camera. Paul's got 15 cameras here, so I never know which way to turn.
That's your primary angle.
Jesse's telling me things that I don't want to hear. All right, we're going to get rolling here shortly. We got an exciting event coming up Thursday, 6 p.m. Write it down. You might have heard us advertising a little bit about it. Write it down. 6 p.m. Open house. Open house. International Academy of Flint. If you are considering going to another school, we would ask you to give us some serious, serious thought and come and visit us. We will have parents there. We'll have teachers there. We'll have kids there. We want you to talk with them about why we are doing as well as we do. Because you probably know we've received some awards here nationally and statewide. The most recent, our high school was awarded a bronze medal for the 6th out of 7 years. We are, Miss Johnson, one of America's best high schools, based upon U.S. News and World Report.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you, baby.
Yes.
Yeah, that's, don't look at me. I have very little to do with that. That's our kids, our parents, and our wonderfully dedicated teachers, and I mean that with, are words not just slipping off my tongue. Those are words that we really, really mean, because they really, really are very committed. And, of course, this wouldn't work if the kids didn't want to work hard. And, of course, those parents and those homes that support what we do. It's a circle. There's 3 points, and that's what's really a triangle. There's three things that have to work. Parents have to work with kids. Kids have to work with themselves, and we have to do the right thing. And somehow, that's all coming together. So, folks, we want you to know about our open house on Thursday, 6 p.m., If you got a question, call 600-5000. What a simple number, 600-5000. And we will guide you or give you questions and answer your questions, hopefully guide you to our meeting. And we'll take tours of the school. We'll have a bang-up good old time. You ever heard of a bang-up good old time, Miss Johnson?
No.
Oh, she hadn't. Okay, she's being very, very courteous now. This is a bang-up good time lady here. She's a wonderful lady. And I think we should... I know we're going to get a call. In fact, audience, I want to prepare you for this. We have one of our staff members' daughter is going to have a fundraiser for a breast cancer situation. Mm-hmm. So we've asked her to call in. This, as you know, a very sensitive and a serious issue. And we're going to have her call in and give us some information. I have the flyer here, but we'll let her make the phone call. And particularly members of... Ebenezer Baptist Church, and that'll be given, a flyer will be given to you tomorrow morning about this event. So please do. This is a situation that, of course, none of us would ever want to experience, but somehow some are chosen to do this, and we trust that this would be a very effective fundraiser for this particular young lady. All right, Miss Johnson, I bragged about you. And she is with, what organization are you with? I can't remember.
Okay. My full-time job is with the Greater Flint Arts Council.
Okay.
And what I do on my off time is work with McCree Theater on the north end of town. But I do several other things around, and I'm back in school. So I'm working on a master's degree.
Well, oh, with who then?
Is it locally? Eastern Michigan University.
Oh, EMU. Okay. And would it be in the drama field?
You better believe it.
Oh, of course, of course.
Of course.
Even I, a clueless person, could figure that
Absolutely.
Out.
Absolutely. Okay. Anybody who knows me knows.
So what will the degree be called then? Master's in?
I'm going for communications, drama, and theater for the young audiences, which I'm prayerfully going for the Master's of Fine Arts. Which is a terminal
MFA
degree.
Yes, right. Yes, indeed. What a marvelous thing. Absolutely. Well, you bring to that program, wherever you are, whether it be Eastern or Hoogie Toogie Land, wherever you'd be earning your degree, you will bring to that program a wealth of experience, knowledge, and expertise.
Thank
so I'm
you.
Sure, oh, I mean, you know, I've loved you for years. You've done such good things for Flint kids and families. Yeah, you're just marvelous. And I know that I would presume in this class you will get to demonstrate some of your existing skills and do skits and things at all. Is it any of it impromptu, or is it all
no,
kind
it's
of hardcore
be,
learning?
No, yeah. You got to do what they call the forerunners, okay. People I've never heard of, only one of them, but Viola Spolin, I've heard of her as the improv queen. But I'm learning about Nellie McCaslin, who I had no idea about. And Winifred, and I can't even think of her last name. So there's new people that I'm learning about, but I'm a little concerned about the courses because they're all Eurocentric, and I'm wondering what were the Native Americans doing, the Arabics, the African Americans. Where were we in the scope of developing or helping with the theater for young audiences. Mm-hmm. So that might be my mission while I'm there, is to bring that opening.
You could impact that entire curriculum.
Probably
that's
could.
Your assignment, young lady.
Thank you, sir.
Yes,
I will accept it gladly.
Thank you. Thank you. And Greater Flint's Art Council, folks, right on South Saginaw Street.
Absolutely.
Right near Court Street, and I think you've driven by 100 times and always seen something exciting in the window.
Yes.
And a great place. If you got a few minutes, now who does, but if you do have, you ought to drop in. There's all kind of art stuff on the walls in there. It's just a beautiful place. And they have guest artists, and they have kids stuff in there, and it's a great
it's
place
phenomenal.
To be. It is.
It's
it is.
Phenomenal.
And let's give a little shout out to your director.
Greg Fiedler. Call him the Fiedler Man.
Okay. Might he be listening at this time of day?
I have no idea.
Okay. Well, if you are, Greg, thanks for the great job you do.
Well, no, he wouldn't be because he's up north.
Oh, okay. All right. Very good. Well, we have a long antenna that might reach up there. Okay. Well, listen, we're going to have you talk about why you're here. And you came for a special program at a certain location, so why don't you tell us about that program, which
not
I think is...
Not a problem. Mm-hmm. Our biggest thing over at McCree Theater right now is the production called Mr. Personality, the Lloyd Price story. Charles Winfrey wrote this particular...
Did he?
Yeah, he wrote this one. He's very historically based, and McCree Theater does a lot of different types of things, but... Here the music and the performers are so stylized and so, I mean, they bring grace to the stage. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen such a wonderful cast of performers in a long time. And not saying that past performers weren't, but I barely touched these people, and they brought with them what they had. Mm-hmm. And what I mean by is shaping and molding. Mm-hmm. And gave a young lady an opportunity to use her skills as a dancer. And Kathleen Kirby saw it worthy to mention the dance in a song called I Cry by Laverne Baker. And I set a dance and designed what it was I wanted it to look like, the concept, why she was doing this. And she developed it very well, so I didn't have to choreograph that piece at all. The only thing I did was talk her through certain things of it so that it makes it a little more effective.
Now, are the artists that are doing this, are they already firm as to what roles they're playing?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, could you want to mention a few names? Maybe I'd recognize one or two.
We got Billy Scott Lindo, who is a stable at McCree Theater. Bruce, I don't know your last name, but he used to sing with a group called Unique. And Hawthorne. Bruce
Hawthorne. Paul Herring knows him. Thank you, Paul Herring.
I mean, I've never seen this man perform by himself, and I got an opportunity to watch him, and I had to go to him afterwards and ask him, who are your mentors? And also suggested to him that he not try to develop a group, but to go solo.
On his own.
Absolutely.
Wow.
If I had an agency, he would be one I would put in it to promote in the business of entertainment, because he's that smooth on the stage, and he connects with an audience. Then you got Ricky Williams, who does a marvelous job with the song that he does. I got my son, Lawrence Christopher Young, who is playing the young Lloyd Price, and he is just phenomenal. And then the older Lloyd Price is by Rod Green, who is in the community as a coach for a girls' track team.
I recognized that name when you said that.
Absolutely.
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely. And he's doing a fantastic job. And he's this is his second production with McCree. He did Dream Girls with us when we collaborated with community players. And he is doing a fabulous job as the older Lloyd Price. I know I'm going to forget somebody because names.
That's the problem.
You always do that. Little Whitney, who I've watched grow. She's doing Pata Pata by Miriam Makeba. And there's a dance that goes with that. And we got Patricia, and her last name I can't remember right now, but she also sings I Cried a Tear. And we interchange the artists with the women. And Billy does it sometimes, and Leona does it sometimes, and Patricia.
Mm-hmm.
And then we've got...
versatile group, huh?
Very versatile.
Really?
Versatile. There's all kinds of things that's happening in and out of this production that you don't even expect. And we got Cassandra Wilson, and she happens to be the DJ, the mic at the twilight.
Okay.
Where she brings you W Soul Radio, and it's just phenomenal, you know. And
I'm the baboon at noon here.
they keep developing because there's always more. The more you do it, the more you bring to the production.
Uh-huh.
And we even bring the spinners on. We got a James Brown act, and the ladies are out there dancing, and it's just phenomenal.
Well, when is it going to happen, please?
It's going to happen this afternoon at 3 and 8 o'clock.
No, I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and this is so timely.
Very timely.
Folks, listen up. Go on over there. Do it again.
3 and 8. Come on by.
Okay.
And
where's McCree Theater? Never heard of it. Tell us where it is.
It's on Pearson Road in Clover Lawn, right across from Shorthorn. Okay. It's the old Selby School. Selby School.
No, you're right. Selby School. Yeah, I can identify that.
And it used to be the Urban League, and now it's McCree Theater.
Sure is. Okay.
Run by
Paul has a hand up. I don't know if he's testing. Is there a wind in here, Paul?
I have a question.
Question?
I have a question. I got an email from Judge Marable. Is he still working with you guys?
And Judge Marable is in it also.
Okay.
He's singing Short Fat Fanny. And let me tell you something. You something about Judge Marable. He's stepping in where we need him. I mean, he's doing such a wonderful job. Thanks for bringing that up. And I don't know, he might have missed his calling, because the dude is quite a character. I mean, he works that song, and if you know anything about Judge Marable, you know he also does karaoke around the community.
I've heard that, yes, ma'am.
And he's won awards doing it.
Yeah. Okay.
And our music director, Philip Young, he and Charles put their heads together and said, you know, we need somebody to fill this spot, and they thought of him, and we went and We actually came down on him, and we sought him out down at Churchill. So he's been with us ever since. And then we got a Troy Swanigan, who has been doing a marvelous job, who came in at the last moment, and Justin also, who came in at the last minute. And they're just pitching in. This cast is phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
What they bring to the stage is more than phenomenal. Mm-hmm. It is totally awesome.
Well,
ticket
prices. Hit that, girl. I think we're about to get
the
a call
prices.
In, but let's get that out before
let's
we get interrupted. Huh?
See, that's the part I don't work on the most.
Well, make something up.
For seniors and students, it's $10 in advance. For adults, it's $15 in advance and $18 at the door, and $12 at the door for students and seniors.
And seating, now that's in the old Selby Auditorium. Must be seating for 200 in there? What would there be?
About 200.
I'm guessing.
Yeah, and we got new seats, so they're very comfortable.
Okay. Right.
When the cinema shut down, they donated the seats to us, and we have those
nice.
In there. Oh, yeah.
Very good. Thank you.
And you can buy a seat for $50, and your name is put on it.
Oh, wow.
And there's a...
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And you know, whatever you can do to help the theater, it's a very iconic and needs to stay in our communities.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And hats off to Charles Winfrey for his playwriting abilities.
He's
my
been
goodness.
Doing it for years.
Wow.
I've been doing his shows for years, and they're always been challenging and very satisfying once they put up. And he stays connected to them.
Jess, do we have a call? We did not have a call.
No.
Oh, I thought I saw you go to the phone. That's
what I was
saying.
That was MCI.
Oh, okay.
If you want to switch long distance company.
Okay.
Can you hear me now?
That was a PSA or something like that? Wow. Giving them free pub.
Well, Mr. Johnson, that's great. I needed to maybe make an announcement here. I told our good folks with the Flint, our police department, that would mention something. On this coming May 22nd, which is next Wednesday, 7 o'clock at Southwestern Academy, May 22nd, 7 p.m., Southwestern Academy. The Detroit Lions are in town. This is their annual basketball game with the Flint Order of Police All-Stars, and it's entertaining. I mean, you're not going to see the first team there from the Lions, or the first team from the Detroit Pistons or anything, but many of these Lions can play ball. These are excellent professional athletes with a variety of abilities, and I think some of you will be surprised at how well these big guys can move on a court. I've been there for a couple of them, and we have free tickets available for you. Come on to school, International Academy, 2820 South Saginaw, and you'll be able to pick up a ticket or two there. We have a handful. So it's first come, first serve, folks. That's the way it'll go. But we support them. We appreciate our police department and all that they do under stressful conditions. So we're trying to support this event for them. And please come by our school, 2820 South Saginaw. Free ticket. F-R-E-E-E-E. Never a good speller.
Free.
That's the word. That's the word for that on Wednesday the 22nd at 7 p.m. And then I got another little, Jesse, we're going to have give away three things here from McDonald's. Sam Cox over at his restaurants is giving away, gave me a couple of these. We're going to give them away during school this week. But we have a medium McCafe, is that McCafe? McCafe, is that how we're saying that word? Beverage of your choice at any of the Michigan McDonald's restaurants. So there's three of those here, Jess. I'm going to leave them with you. And folks, in fact, no, we should do a call-in. That's what we'll do. And the first three people that call in can have these. Is that all right to do? Okay, Paul's going to run out right now. Paul's running out to make a phone call. He's so honest and cheerful, purple people, honest. But if you want to call in, 239-5733, dial that phone. Yes,
and at this point, and I haven't talked with Charles about it, but I'd be willing to add a free ticket to the 3 or 8 o'clock show to McCree Theater.
And what's that number that I'm going to dial right now?
787-2200.
We're nuts, but that's great.
That's okay.
Oh, that's great.
But if they
that
dial in,
so generous of you. Thank you.
I will take care
when
of it.
When is the call-in for those coupons for the...
Right now.
Is it for the McCafe, or is it for the tickets for the Lions?
The Lions they have to go to school for.
And the one from McCree, just
call
here.
The tickets for the Lions you got to pick up at the at the school, but the McCafe coupons you can pick up here.
Well, actually, they can call McCree and say, Kathy said it on the radio.
Okay.
I'll take care of it when I get there.
All right, so if they call the McCree number and say, Kathy said it on the radio, and you're the first caller, right?
First caller.
Okay.
Only one caller, please.
Okay.
I will definitely take care of that.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you
very kindly.
Paul has another question.
I have another question.
You there in the back row. Paul.
This question is for you, Mr. Winslow. Paul Herring Spectacle Productions. I read in the newspaper that one of the charter schools was closing down, and I'm wondering how that's affecting you at International Academy.
Me personally, not at all. We're never, it's never a good thing for an organization in Flint to not do their very best. And they're... There might be closing here. That's very true. All right. With that said, in fact, we have young people already at our school this morning. I mentioned we were testing. We have children there from Academy of Flint right now taking our diagnostic tests. So that may affect where those children may wish to come. We, of course, would naturally welcome them. I personally know the director and the principal at Academy of Flint. They're good people, strong educators.
Right.
I'm just sorry that's occurring. Jesse, a question?
Ms.
Johnson,
lady on the phone.
Okay.
She said that Kathy said that they're giving away tickets to the...
One ticket?
Uno. Just one ticket?
Uno makes
one
uno.
Ticket.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
you're only giving away one ticket for that.
Do you want her name right now? Or
no, she has to call the
call
theater.
The station.
I think so.
All
right, we're going to proceed here while Jesse's carrying on a conversation with one of the listeners. And thank you for listening, whomever you might be. Now, those medium McCafe, or if I'm pronouncing it right, I'm not a... I eat breakfast at McDonald's sometimes, but I don't read all this other stuff. But the free beverage at the McDonald's of your choice. Pick that up here at WFLT, right here at 370 or 371 South Averill. Great little place here. Great little place. Now we have a call.
Gentleman has a question for you.
Very good, sir. Thank you. Hi, caller. Thank you for listening. How may we assist you, sir?
Yes. Good morning, Dr. Roosevelt. You're a guest there. Good morning,
sir. Good morning.
Okay. Good morning to you as well. What, your question, sir?
I know your audience is aware of how the International Academy nurtures the kids and the community and their minds and their body. I was wondering about that farmer's market that you guys have across the street from the International Academy on South Sinai.
Oh, great question. Thank you for calling. I forgot to even think about that lately. Wow, thanks so much. Yes, we'll have another farmer's market, South Branch of the real farmer's market. And folks, the stuff you heard about the farmer's market closing and moving downtown, that's not going to happen, you know, for at least a year, I believe. But anyway, this summer we will be a southern site, a branch of the farmer's market. Our day will be Monday. Goes from 3 o'clock in the afternoon till 7 in the evening, and that will occur, I believe, the last week in June. Some of that, of course, is depending upon weather, if there's adequate rain and adequate sun, and vegetables have good growing seasons, then they will begin, I believe, the last weekend in June. It's literally, dry caller, thank you so much, literally right across from our school at the intersection of Saginaw and Oakley. And there are about 5, 6, 8, depends on the Monday, trucks that come in there with nothing but vibrant fruits and vegetables. And they set up shop right there. And I know that special deal that they got works there as well. And it's bucks, 20 bucks for something or whatever it is. I don't have the right phraseology.
Double up buck.
Paul Herring to the rescue again. Paul. You are something else, I'm telling you. You certainly are something else. There's all kind of things about that. But we are very proud of you, Paul. Thank you for remembering that. Double Up Bucks works at International Academy of Flint Food or Farmers Market, I think beginning, cooperating, the last weekend in June. It'll run through the summer. And we're developing another parking lot as well at our school. We've acquired some property there. And I think we'll be able to put the parents only in the parking lot where the market will occur at. So that way it could go till 7 o'clock without interruption on Mondays. So caller, thank you for calling. Well, you are a brilliant man. Thank you.
5 minutes hard.
I'm giving you a honk. Okay, there we go. All right, Miss Anderson, Miss Johnson, forgive me. Listen, yeah, whoever you are.
I'm Kathy.
And a great lady, and I've given you all kind of kudos for your personal individual skills now that you're going after your MFA from EMU University. Wow, what a thrill.
Yes.
What about Greater Flint's Art Council? Can you give us a plug about what's happening there?
Presently, we have the University of Michigan Student Jury Exhibition there.
Ooh.
And every month, second
for
Friday.
For sale, even?
There's things there that are for sale, absolutely. And it's some very good art. And we have also, every second Friday of every month, we have an opening for the art openings. And so it's free and open to the public. It's the biggest date you could bring a date on. It's free. And we also serve beverages and food.
Love it.
6 o'clock is when we start serving. You show up at 5:30, we will hold you until 6 o'clock. We also have music during that time.
Paul will be there at 5:48. I know.
No, Paul comes around 6:30, quarter to 7, and misses the food.
He misses the food.
Okay. But he does come, and it's always good to see him walk in the door. And Jazz Walk is one of the things that we have at the Greater Flint Arts Council. That is the fourth Thursday of every month in the downtown Flint area. We also just got through holding a Share Art Flint Grant Awards, and those awards will be coming out by the end of this month of people who wanted to do an art project in the communities. I don't know. I didn't get a chance to read any of them, but that's going to happen. And they're using community people to review those grants.
Okay.
And those grants were up to $5,000.
Yes, right.
We also have the Michigan Council for Arts
but
and Cultural Affairs.
Where does
Affairs.
That money come from?
That particular pot of money comes from the Ruth Mott Foundation.
They're great people. Just
absolutely.
Great people.
We also have the Jazz Festival coming up in August, the first weekend, 2nd through the 4th. And we almost got everybody lined up. We got Hot Club of Detroit coming. We're looking at Robbie Coltrane. We're looking at Del Faro Marcellus. Wynton Marcellus's brother, who plays trombone. Because
that impressed Jesse. Jesse went, wow.
Yeah. Well, we want to pay homage to our late Sherm Mitchell.
Indeed.
Who passed on.
Indeed.
And
absolutely.
So we're looking for a trombone player from the national, international arena to do that with.
Wow.
So we're going to truly miss Sherm. I used to call him all the time just to check on him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to truly miss him.
Mm-hmm.
And there's just so many wonderful things that the Arts Council is doing in the community that people don't even know that Greg is doing many of these things.
Mm-hmm. Juneteenth.
And Juneteenth, but that's your program, Parade of Festivals,
yep.
Which we have 20 festivals that we market for the festivals that are happening in downtown Flint and in the Cultural Center. So that we have great programs that go on. But the amazing thing that people don't know is that there's only two of us that are full-time staff that make this mm-hmm. work.
Okay. What you do is phenomenal, if
Thank
I may
you.
Say so. I
Thank
participated
you,
in one of those art walks this past...
You had fun too, didn't you?
I had an artist there that invited me, so I had to check him out. That's Chris Watson, good friend, very, very talented.
Yeah,
he did
downtown,
a large mural down on
yes,
South
he
Saginaw.
Did. And we do that second Friday art walk with all the businesses that want to be a part of it.
That's great. Yeah,
good. Gives them opportunities.
It's just really good. There's
networking.
Absolutely.
And collaboration.
So we're glad. We should have you on more often, Ms. Johnson. Yeah.
I would come.
Yeah.
It's about the right time on a Saturday morning.
Okay. Well, folks, don't forget, I got to hit our open house again, May 23rd, 6 o'clock p.m. Please. If you have grandchildren, children that might want to consider changing schools, and in light of what Paul Herring just brought up about the closing of Academy of Flint, why don't you give us a look? 6 o'clock, May 23rd, and it'll be about an hour or so, and we'll give you a tour of the building and such. And we're going to ask you to give that serious consideration. And with that being said, we usually close off in this fashion. And I'm going to have you join us, Ms. Johnson, if you can read all those big O's down there. Wherever you are, folks, if you are walking your dog, should you be looking at a blog, or suppose you are lavishly looking at lovely lollipops while lingering lonesomely in the luminous light of luxurious landlocked lagoons in Lebanon, look at somebody and say, that is some kind of school. Bye, everybody.